the M-20 bridge project over the Tittabawassee River in Midland was a two-year project. We basically, the old bridge was at nearing the end of its life cycle. There's actually two bridges. They are right next to each other, so it looks like they are one complete bridge. We constructed the first section last year through the winter and opened it up this spring. That allowed us to detour traffic onto that earlier this year. Then we started construction on the second bridge. There was a major safety improvement with the new bridge. The old bridge was 6 feet taller than the new bridge. So we lowered the new bridge 6 feet. So that definitely has improved the safety of the motoring public who are coming into the city of Midland. They now can very easily see the signal at the Main Street intersection, where before it was really difficult to see that signal until you were right up onto it.
That's huge. I mean, there was some signs ahead, beforehand, and tried to notify people of signals, but you're coming in off a highway and that vertical curve as you came up, and then all of a sudden, hey, there's a street and an intersection and a signal. Sometimes it was red, sometimes you got the green light, and so speeds were high, and so having it flatter than it was really improves the safety component. And so from a city perspective, that's a great thing. And that was one of the key things that was talked about throughout the whole process and through the design was the improvement that would make.
The motoring public will notice that in the middle of the bridge, the wall is a lot taller than it used to. We have designed that and constructed it with a glare screen in there. The glare screen helps prevent oncoming traffic's headlights from getting into your eyes, makes it a little difficult to see. During design of the bridge, we worked very closely with the local community to get their input on what they would want the new bridge to look like. They gave input onto the street lights that we now installed. There's a static stone that's under on the bridge walls that was the input from the public and from the city and the county. We also, the red railing, that was input from the city.
Large bridges are kind of landmarks. And so one component is the red railing along there. Not very many bridges have a nice color to it, and that rail really kind of brings a pop to the bridge and offers kind of a unique Midland component to having a red railing on the bridge. So really kind of says, hey, welcome to Midland, you're here as an entrance into the community. And so that's a great thing. And that collaboration was so important. So I think that collaboration and that community involvement, I think it really meant that, MDOT wasn't just here to do a bridge and get out of town. They wanted something that the city and residents could recognize and could have input in and work as a team and collaborate on. It wasn't just MDOT's moving in and doing a project and then getting out. It was, a community project for the benefit of everybody. And so it was really nice to see that.
I want to thank the public, and I hope the public is as excited as we are. We have worked hard with our contractors, our consultants, the local community to provide a product, a bridge that we hope that everybody will enjoy as much as we do.